sort of pull from. We've had really serious, serious budget cuts. You may remember that I brought up last time that the governor had come back. He'd asked for originally a 3% cut this year's budget. Came back about a month and a half ago, almost 2 months ago, and requested another 3% this year, which is a 6% for this year. And then the DFACS department, Department of Family Children Services, who has been giving a 10% temporary assistance to these families for about 20, 25 years, opted to take their 3%, not giving that money to us, the Department of Public Health, and keeping that money this year, which had shifted us to about a 10% cut this year. That having been said, you look at the very top part, the state reductions were at the top, and all those reductions, 58% were going to be taken at the state level. One of the things Dr. Fitzgerald did is in the HR department at the state level, every member of HR department was asked to run a national inventory of popular jobs, and they're in the process now of doing their interviews, but there will be a streamlined at the state level. But if you look at the district grant aid programs, we had already addressed the grant aid allocation for hypertension with the SHAP program that you all know been going on here for 25 or so years, that we actually terminated last year, so that really didn't affect us significantly. It did affect a lot of districts throughout the South State, but not what we did done last year. Oral health has been transferred to federal funds, and they had the option of doing that. They did that, which reduced that. Genetics claim fund, CMS, Children's Medical Services, Children's Health Services, was also reduced. We, however, found that really a couple weeks ago we got a call that they were rethinking that. And the last cut we got finalized actually last Thursday and last Friday, which had to do with, again, services that are, let's just say, family planning. Originally, they'd take a lot for family planning. We had made the adjustments to that. We think that was part of the TANF issue. They came back since the election. Found some money, and we're not, that cut's not going to be as bad as we thought it was going to be. And we don't know the final numbers on that, but the other program that has been significantly impacted is Baby Can't Wait, which you know is for children with developmental, both behavioral and physical problems. We have ended up in intensive meetings both last Friday and yesterday, finalized the cuts to that. The total number of actual losses would be, for the period, it would be about 4. There was one that occurred this time. It was clerical, and that was here, one additional cut. All together, and with this cut, it was approximately 10 positions that have been lost. We're in a lot better shape than most of the regions. And may not believe that is true. We have some, literally, the base can't wait. We still have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 employees. We have some that have enough funds just for coordinating one person. That's not us. I hope and think what's happened this year, the ERA funds, the Recovery and Readjustment Act, died as of last July. And this year there are no ERA funds, and of course the governor has asked, I said, for 6% cut in this year, but he's also carried forward another 3% cut in 2014 budget, which we have not addressed yet, but in carrying it forward with our accountant yesterday, and Cherry White, the district administrator, she feels, and Babies Can't Wait to talk to Judy Brooker and Link yesterday and Friday, several of you, that we're going to be okay next year with regard, because we we've come in somewhat, we've been proactive in addressing this, knowing that it was going to happen, even though they came back and asked us, but they can't wait about a month ago. Initiatives cut, hold off, let's get our final figures together, but they came to us last Thursday. We were very glad that we've gone ahead and been proactive for any of a number of reasons. The bottom line was that we ended up having to make those cuts that we thought we were gonna have to make. One additional cut, it's clerical. We do have a still a functioning program. Do not think we'll do it in 2014 in a lot better shape. I think and hope and do think that this year, and I said that last year, next year's gonna be a bad year. It has been a bad year. We hope and think that this will be the worst year that we have. Do I know that? Sure, absolutely not. Say that with a great deal of confidence. No. Do I think that's true? Yes. And I've told you about as much as I can tell you about the cuts that occurred, why they occurred, and how we address them. I'm sure that's occurring at every level because of state government.